Hello everyone. This video I will show how to custom table cell editor, using JSpinner as cell of table, and allow user to edit and modify the quantity of item cell, and I build this project with flatlaf, but you can use another look and feel, it will work well. Here my project I has created, so it have test J frame and flatlaf file style property. In file property I have use accent color, default font, background, foreground, table header height, and table row height. And I have add flatlaf library to this project. So go in test J frame, in main class here, I have installed the flatlaf, so we need load file style property, and here we call flatlaf.setup. So next we going to create new J table. So here we change the column title name and add more column. Unselected editable column, but we allow only quantity column for user can be editing. And remove all row. So next we going to create new class, as model item cell, for table row data. So in this class, we can create any field that we want, and any field that we want to display as table row. Then encapsulation all fields and create constructor. Next create method to table row, for converts their field in this model object to row of J table, so this method should be returned as object array. Here create decimal format object for format number. So the first column index as this, this as the current object, and next column as row number. And next as product name, quantity, price and total. So now we can use this model to create table row as row data. Go to main class, and create method for add data to J table. To add data to J table we need create default table model. Then use method add row, and create model item cell object. For converts this object to table row, we call method to table row, that we have created in class model item cell. Then pass the row count plus 1 for row number. And here we need pass the values to this object. This for example, you can try with another sample. So I can copy it for another row. This is product ID, we do not show it on table, but we use it when we save the data to the database. So after add data, now we can run it. So here we see the column data is contain of object, because we have set the first array of method to table row as the current object, so we going to hide this column. Select on column data, and set the preferred width, max and min to 0. And we change column width for column row number and column name. So next we going to custom the column quantity with JSpinner. Create new class call quantity cell editor. then extends this class with default cell editor, that it from package javax.swing. So in class default cell editor no have default constructor, so when we extends, it required to add one constructor, and call super constructor to initialize member of super class. Here we have three constructor, J text field, J checkbox and J combo box, now I use one as J text field. So I need remove arguments here, and create it direct to the super constructor, so when we create object quantity cell editor, we no need to pass J text field parameter. So next we going to set this custom class to the J table. Use method get column model, and get column at index 3, then use method set cell editor. Now we get the quantity column as the J text field, but we need to double click on the cell to get editing, so we don't want that, we want only one click to start editing cell. So go to change this J text field to J checkbox, but if you want to double click to edit cell, just keep it J text field. Now it work, but when it start editing, the cell value come to true and false, because the checkbox values as the boolean type, so we need to override some method in class cell editor. By override method at table cell editor component. In default this method will return the J checkbox component, so we need to custom this method to return the J spinner component. Create J spinner component here. Then return this input spinner in this method. Now we see the spinner, but when we stop editing cell, or the focus get out from the editing cell, the value still changed to boolean type, so we need to override one more method. Here override method get cell editor value, then return input.getValue, this method work when the cell has stopped editing, then the value have passed from editing cell to component cell render. But we see the input cell keep the last value, and the value has effect to another cell when we editing, so we need to set initial value to the spinner input when we start editing cell. And we want the input must be positive number, and bigger than 0. First we need set minimum value to the J spinner model. And we also can use method set maximum for max value, but am using only minimum. But now we cannot edit, because the value is 0, so we need set initial value to the input spinner. So right here, first get the value from the table as integer, and remember, the method get table cell editor component work when cell begin editing, and method get cell editor value work when cell stop editing, and then pass the value to component cell render. So now it work, but we have another problem. When we input value by keyboard then the focus out cell without press enter, the value return back, so we need set option commit on valid edit to this spinner. First get number editor from spinner. Then get default formatter from text field in object editor by using editor.getTextField. So call formatter.setCommit on valid edit to true. Now it worked. So next I want editor text.center of the cell. By use editor.getText field, then set horizontal alignment to center. Now editor has center but cell render not center, so we need to custom table cell render, by go here. We can copy this code, but we use set cell renderer. And new with class default table cell renderer, then override method get table cell renderer component. So we remove the return here, then use return this. And before return we set horizontal alignment to center. So now we got all has center, and next we going to update the total price when the quantity column has changed. First we need add event change listener to this input spinner, so this event work when the value has been changed. So we can create new method here for input change. Then call it from this event listener. And for this event we can converts it to use lambda expressions. Now get value from input spinner as integer. So we can output the quantity value for test. Now we see on consoles, the value and event are work well. So next, we need create the table object. And row we current editing. And the model item cell object for current row. So we need initialize their object in this method, so it will be set when the cell start editing. For table object is take from the arguments here. And row we take from this row arguments. For the model item cell object, we can get from table at column 0 index, but so we need casting object to model item cell. So remember here, I have used this for current object at the first index, when call method to table row, so we can casting the values at index 0 to model item cell, so it not have any error. So next we go to method input change, and first we need to check it input quantity has changed. It mean the quantity not the same value with quantity in model item cell object. Next create the decimal format object for format the number. So in this condition, we set the new quantity value to the object item cell, and new total as quantity multiply with price. And then set the total to the table value to display to table row. And for the column index as 5. So now we see the total value has changed. But here we have small problem, when we first click on the button JSpinner, the value has been changed, so I need to delay some millisecond after clicked or before editing the cell. So go here, while start editing, we need to disable the spinner by call method set enabled to false. Then create one method to enable editing. And call enable method after disable. But in this method we need use thread to delay. Call thread.sleep and set it to 100 milliseconds, but it error because sleep method need try catch block. So after sleep, now call method to enable input spinner to true, so user now can editing the cell. So next we going to some total amount, and display at the bottom here. Now go to create new class interface, call event cell input change. So in this interface we create one abstract method as input changed. And then go back to class quantity cell editor, and add the class event here. So for this event we need initialize with constructor. Then go to this method, and call event.inputChanged. So here we need create the event here for quantity cell editor. We can output some text for test. Here we see the event has work, so next we can sum the total amount from this table. Create new method call sum amount, then call it from event change. So in this method we use for loop to get all table row. We can get model item cell object from the first index of J table row, by casting object. So when we do like this, we can get all field that have in class model item cell, for example we can use product ID to insert into database. Next go to create new J label to display total amount. Create new decimal format object for format number. Then set total to the J label. But we need call sum amount method at the first. Thank you everyone for watching, see you next video.